Hello, the Zeglin Clock.
And Ripper 95, welcoming you to episode 5 of Let's Play Bionicle, The Mask of Light, which is technically the title of this game.
It's Bionicle the game, but it's about the Mask of Light.
Yeah.
Deepwood, Sister Toa comes with a sorry bad tale.
Toa Lewa, you know what news I bring?
The drums of Mekoro cry tell of sons of Makuta, but without my Suva, I cannot reach the threat.
Where are your Matoran to activate the Suva?
Captured. Lost.
You alone can find them, Lewa Nuva. Find them, free them, and use the Suva to hunt for these sons of Makuta.
Yeah, okay, so they just brought up a really important thing that's not exactly too known to people who just built Bionicles. The Suva is a small cube that gives them a lot of their power. Without their Suva, they kind of don't have their power. This level is actually, I think, the longest in the game. I think they put the most time into this level. I think we're supposed to hit that button.
Oh well.
We'll come back for it. Okay, so we can miss 20 of these. We have to get at least 150 of these light stones.
Yeah. Which I'm sure we'll be all fine. Hey, Cord.
Oh yeah, okay, so you have to get those balloons. Because they're much more on them.
Now we get a swing like Tarzan. Which actually, this whole sequence reminds me a lot of the Tarzan stage from Kingdom Hearts. Like,
I ever told you how much I fucking hate Kingdom Hearts?
Yeah. Well, it's got a terrible fan base. I'll agree with you in that, but like, the people who do like it, like, are sometimes are
eccentric.
Yeah, they're sometimes just very eccentric. I mean, I enjoy the game because it's just got like a type of plot that just, I'll admit the controls are crap and like a lot of the gameplay is just very clunky. It's just got a great story.
They tried to make it too much like an RPG, but have action in it as well.
Yeah. So I just went full circle?
Yeah, which is good because you have to go through that again so you can get that one control and you miss.
Yeah. I don't know how to dodge that.
They are really generous with lives in this game.
You mean by generous they have in their lives, right?
Yeah, and how they have their health system and death and so on. Yeah. Because, going back to the Suva thing, with, Liwa's Suva, I think his was actually the first one to be captured by the, Borak Kal in that story arc. And when that happened, the Borak got the Suva and literally sucked all of the air out of the room, starting to suffocate the,
I just committed suicide to get the scene sooner.
Wow, really? That's what you did?
Yeah.
And if you look on the left pillar there, you can actually see Lewa's original mask.
Yeah. Let's see what the suit is like. Is it gonna be like a teleport gate? Like Stargate SG-1?
I like the movie more.
The movie Stargate SG-1?
No, just the movie Stargate. The original one, the one from the 80s. Was it the 80s or was it the 90s?
I don't know. Let's just play this game. As the Toa of Air, you have the ability to soar amongst the birds in the treetops of Matadouli. To activate your gliding ability, jump twice and press triangle. Alright. It's pretty simple. Damn it. Why can't I... What the crap?
does a whole triangle? Actually, I think it's not a triangle.
No, I think it's like, well, that's what I've been doing. I keep.
What the hell is going on with this camera? Jesus Christ. What the fuck?
Okay, give me the controller back if you're gonna be bitching about it. At least I didn't bitch too much about it.
There we go. Christ. Okay, yeah, you have to hold it.
Okay. Just Tarzan jump. George of the jungle.
Watch out for that tree. Oh shit. Oh shit, son.
Actually, another thing that you might find interesting.
Whoa, what the Okay, the vine can. What the fuck?
Okay, glitched. You might find interesting that the Bionicle movie has a trailer for George the Jungle 2.
Really?
Yeah. Which is kind of relevant.
To this part only.
Yeah.
Okay, after this you have to jump. Oh, you missed them.
Oh, I can miss 20. And people who are playing this game know where they are at least.
Yeah.
On like the first stage where it's like either we miss them really bad or we're just blind.
No, you're an idiot.
Why? Why?
Because there's another path you could have taken back, but you dumbass. Who knows how many lives so you just missed?
How many do you think I'm getting by this? Oops. You know what? I'll give you that. I'll give it a chance in that other stage. Or not. Never mind. Damn. What?
Be careful with this because that's a false song.
False branch?
Yeah, it's gonna fall out from you.
What the crap? Everything falling out from under me? Platform.
Should we talk shit about people that we know on here?
I don't see why not. Depends on the person.
Like Antonio.
Yeah, we can talk shit about
Antonio. Oh yeah. You're an egotistical bastard, Antonio. I hope you're watching this. I hate you.
Okay, screw it. The platforms that fell out will come back.
The platform needs to get there, didn't fall. Stupid.
No, some of the platforms collapse on front. The ones that look like rockier. These. See? People just collapsing for the fun of it.
Don't miss this time. There you go. 116.
So like, what the crap? From Lightstone. I like the music of this stage.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, it's fitting.
I'm kind of depressed that I didn't make any more, Bionicle games after this.
They made one more.
Oh.
Bionicle Legends. It's the,
For the console. Did they make another console one?
Yeah, it was, Xbox 360.
Oh.
I know, because the only reason I didn't buy it is I was buying, Transformers instead.
Ah, okay. Well, maybe you'll have to buy that eventually.
Oh, I will.
Oh, wait. No, I remember Legends. That's the one with the, Hulk or something, the Hulkal or some shit like that.
Yeah, it was the fourth story, but it was like It was, it was like the Matoran from this world go and become Toa and save the Matoran from another area. It was like the Matoran Jala. I don't think they even knew show Jala in this yet.
Jala. He's like, oh, I'm gonna become the Toa. I'm late. I'm special. No, you're not. No, you're not, pal.
Oh, okay, I see. You just let it hit you in the face. And then you kind of catch on to it. That's kind of stupid. But who am I to do? What? What the fucking shit? At least it respawned right here. You know what? I have full health now. I'm happy game. As if I can't glide down myself since I'm the Toa of Air, goddammit. What the crap? Save myself in there. Someone's gonna be playing this. It's like, I remember this game. You guys suck at this shit.
Yeah, we kind of do.
Of course, I'm not really here to show off about this game. I'm here to have fun. If you want a channel where people show off, then find a different channel. That's what my Redstone series is about.
Oh, shit. Bubbles. Bubbles! What? Bubbles!
What is this? Am I supposed to, like, stand on them?
So who here is going to see Finding Nemo in 3D this month or next month?
Is it even any different than the original Finding Nemo?
Or
is it
3D.
It's the exact same thing, only 3D.
What are you talking about? That doesn't make it a movie.
No, because they tried to do that with, like, all the other movies, and they all...
Like The Lion King?
Yeah, I mean, Lion King is the Lion King, no matter how many times you change Lion King.
Lion King 2.5?
What? No, that was 1.5.
Oh, 1.5.
That was the Timon and Pumbaa one.
Yeah. I'm sorry, but I don't think that of those characters, of like all the characters in that movie, you could make a spin-off show about them.
The great cuckoo bird possesses the strongest wings of any bird of this fair island. The updraft crane with this fiber will enable you to glide huge distances to stay aloft. Who the fuck uses aloft?
Especially in a children's game.
So you want to use this bird to,
Okay, we just unlocked the, thingy, the art book, I think.
The second one. We still need to get the first one first.
Fuck you, Kohaka.
Oh. What? God damn you.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Okay, thanks, bird. Never mind. Oh, I stand on it, don't I? Oh, no. Okay. Oh, no, no. This song sucks. Triana. Your name's Rihanna. Oh.
Rakshi. This one's the brown one, so...
It's like...
Actually, I think he's one. Because, like, they really fucked up the colors and shit.
So let's, like, mimic his movements in this one.
I think so.
That's what I'm gonna go with. Come at me, motherfucker. Okay, so I can't do that.
You can't touch the water, I think. Try seeing if he mirrors your moves.
Well, he moves first. Oh, I have to get him to just try to... land on all these broken things.
Yeah.
I see. Come here.
Actually, I think you have to have him destroy all of them except for the one you're standing on. Just try to get the itchy. Oh, wait, did they come back?
Yeah, I have to get him to land in the water.
Oh,
maybe I've not seen the water. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Anywhere you can... Come at me, Sam. I heard some maybe he is on water. I think he's stuck. Not that I know that without looking at my computer. This is so cryptic. This whole boss is cryptic.
Yeah. I mean, at least in Doom 3, when you're fighting the final boss, it tells you how to beat him. Well, not the final boss, the Guardian tells you how to defeat, but...
Oh wait, can I hit this platform? Oh, yes I can. Okay. Okay, so you know, I can break his platform just as much as he can break mine.
So that's what you want to do. Well, get him isolated first. Try to isolate him, get him to break someone's around him, and then knock his out.
Like
wow!
That's how you kill Araxi, motherfuckers. That's... No! They don't drop Krana!
They drop Chrono.
No, they don't.
I thought it was Chrono.
That's saying Krana with an accent, buddy.
No, they swap the A's with O's, and because it mutates, like it mutates itself.
No, there's the Krana call, and then after that, there's like the snake demons. What time is it?
It's... It's 1:42, maybe?
The mask I found was the mask of light. The Toa sent me on a quest to find the seventh Toa.
Seventh Toa?
A Toa of light. Only the seventh Toa can wear the mask.
And where is the seventh Toa?
I don't know. And now I've lost the mask to these creatures, and they're heading to destroy the coral.
The Toa say they are Rakshi, the sons of the Makuta, deadliest of foes.
I'll do this, Tahu Nuva Sage.
I will deal with the rock ship.
I think we have to get 130 on this level
in order to get the secret. Yeah. Oh yeah.
Why is the ice guy in here? Shouldn't he be dead by now?
I don't know, because he really isn't like an ice guy. He's just like he's white like the ice guy. He just keep the color palette the same. So wait, so peace?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's okay to let him get ahead at that point because he'll stagger when he hits those.
I don't know why I'm racing against Rush.
They're racing against the Koro faster.
Let's get to the Koro.
It's bad that I forgot what a Koro was.
No, that's not bad at all. You can hit them in Moso to get a little bit of a distance on him. I'm ahead of him, aren't I?
Yeah, I know. Imagine how super people look like those must be right now.
They're melting. What was that joke about somebody melting themselves into Legos so children can play with them?
Oh god, Michael Jackson. Oh, okay. Yeah, there was a really bad Michael Jackson joke out there for a little bit after he died that people were saying that the last plastic surgery he was going to have is so that he turned some of those so kids could play with him still. Which I thought offensive, but Michael Jackson didn't even do.
And actually, like a lot of people that said he molested children actually came out and said no, the media was just paying us to say that anyway.
Really?
They did.
I didn't hear that. I just remember hearing that one one of the kids that did it, actually people overheard them saying that they were doing it for money in the first place. Yeah,
they're only doing it for money, and then the media started, like, a few news channels actually started paying them to keep saying it.
Wow. That's depressing that that could happen to society.
Yeah, and no one really knew about it until after. The fact that, like, people say, still say, oh, no, he was a child molester, it pisses me off, because, yeah. No, people are just asking.
Yeah.
It ruined his image.
Oh my god, I fucking served my cousin in his own house one time on that subject. He was like, he had made some side comment about Michael Jackson touching kids. And I'm like, well, you know, he's like, I don't know how white people still like him and white people are like so sorry and everything. I'm like, well, you know, it's because some people choose to judge people by their contributions to music and to society, not by the hearsay that other stupid people say.
Okay, so if you don't win, this is what happens. We didn't intentionally try to show you this, but it kind of just happened that way.
Yeah, you gotta suck.
It doesn't show the village burning in this version.
Oh my god, we start all the way back? Oh,
okay.
Jesus. I really grab my grandfather doesn't watch this.
Why?
Because he's really, really religious. I get really pissed by people saying, Jesus Christ.
Mother.
Wow.
That happened. Where'd he go?
I don't know. But yeah, there are certain points where you have to be ahead of him, otherwise you lose. Because that was only like 2/3 of the way through the actual level.
So he just cleared that out so I could lose him to that advantage. And then hit him in the ass.
You do realize that there's a speed up button, correct?
Yeah, I know. If I get him stuck with these pincers,
I don't really know.
That would be cool. It'd be a lot easier to win this.
Wave, did you ever go to arcades when you were a kid?
Yes. I still go to arcades.
Did you play the that one like snowmobile game, like the one snowmobile race game where it was like you were actually sitting on like a big snowmobile?
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, I would always go to like the haunted house level, like the creepy level. And for some reason, this is reminding me of it. The Stanford things back there remind me of it.
Myself, when I went to a card, I usually would play like House of the Dead.
Oh yeah, just a fucking zombie fetish.
Actually, zombie fetish makes it kind of sound more like a
necrophilia, yeah.
Or like either that or like kind of like furry porn. Type of thing.
Wow, we just got a power surge that's lagging the fuck out of everything. So if you just dropped major frames right there, don't be surprised. I thought that was on our end too.
Yeah. Okay. Hopefully our voices didn't drop frames. I'm talking about frames. God damn you! Oh, that's not even cool. That's not cool, bro. Don't tell that story again.
Fun fact. Speaking of frame droppings on this, like I was thinking, since this game was kind of old, Mario Kart 64 actually didn't have music playing. You split screened it because it was using so much memory on the 64 that. They couldn't support the music in it.
God damn it.
It would just shut off the music if you split-screened it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That sucks.
They brought that up in the Runaway Guys Let's Play, I think. I didn't know that then.
Huh.
Okay, so if I give this one or two more tries...
The mask I found.
Yeah, we'll give it one more try, and then we'll off-screen it. Then open up the next thing with like the scene that's played at the end.
Because this is the last scripted mission that we have.
The only other mission is the end boss mission.
Yeah. But that's not really scripted on the main page. That they don't really let you just jump right to that.
Well, they really don't let you jump to this either.
Yeah, that's right. This one is not on the list either, is it? I kind of like the rock shit cry.
Yeah.
This looks a lot better in color than it does in black and white.
Hell yeah, it does. Everything does. Even those old black and white films that they had to remaster by like adding color to it, they look better in color. Well, to a certain extent, because the recoloring of the original Night of the Dead was just terrible, because they end up giving like one of the characters pink hair by mistake, trying to give him like red hair.
Yeah, because what they actually have to do when they do that is they have to go in and get the negatives of the film, well, not the negatives, but negatives of the film, and hand color it.
Yeah, so if any of that color fades, like, in the process, then they're screwed over. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, I think there's no way you're getting the amount of light stuns you need.
Yeah. Well, we already unlocked the combat card. So we should...
Yeah.
Son of a bitch. Well, I'm worried more about beating this guy than collecting light stones right now, to be completely honest. Okay.
Now, the reason why you're saying, well, EC and Ripper 95, you're hitting this guy with energy bolts. Why is he not dying? Because the Rakshi have this really weird energy absorption thing where it's like a shield and it like morphs around their shield to their staff and gets expelled via their staff.
Yeah. It's kind of weird and complex, but I guess that way it's Ryan explained it better than I could. So
yeah.
That's all that counts. The fact that one of us could explain some shit. Like, I know there's a line, if and when I do a Kingdom Hearts Let's Play, all the shit that you'll never be able to explain to save your life, that I'm like, oh yeah, it's just like this. Or like Matrix the Game.
Oh god. Matrix 2 the Game, with better CGI than the movie.
Yeah, true story.
I went there, Miramax, come at me.
True story, bro.
Even though I don't really have a problem with the animation, I haven't really been critiqued it enough.
That's because you've only ever really seen it, like, once or twice.
I've seen it once. I've seen all the movies once, and I hated them. The first one was decent. The second two didn't need to be made.
Fourth.
Was there a fourth one?
I don't know. There was the Animatrix.
Oh, okay. Because I remember one and two. One, Reloaded Shit. And Revolution.
Yeah, it was one, then Reloaded, then Evolution, then Animatrix.
Okay.
And Animatrix was good because it was like a prequel sequel and like a side story all at the same time. Like, it explains like how the world was overtaken by robots, like how Zion was formed. There was like a ship reference that explains like how that ship was like destroyed.
I don't understand what... Oh, yeah, that's right, because... The one thing that I never understood was, how did the one person first wake up in order to start the revolution? And then the guy like, explained that, like, how he wakes, like, one person up, like, every so often. And the first thing, it's just, like, a vicious cycle. Because I have to think, the idea of that I kind of like.
I think it's just, like, clones, because in a world where they could...
Nah, because he explained it. It was an infinite loop, because he designed it to be a paradox. Except Neo wasn't in his calculations, I think. It was supposed to be that every now and then he wakes up one person, and that one person is supposed to give them a challenge and, like, try to overthrow the machine. And they always fail, like, he always stops them. And, they don't succeed. And so... They all.
And it's just a way of making himself smarter, but Neo had more powers than he had comprehended, being the one.
Yeah.
The one.
Yeah.
The one to end all ones.
The one to rule them all.
Which reminds me of
Lord of the Rings reference there.
Yeah. Actually reminds me of Legendary Frog. Do you remember Legendary Frog?
Barely. So I schooled my friend in Transformers knowledge the other day. Because he had, like, I explained to him that the reason why I hate Beast Wars is because Starscream comes back as his ghost self first. And he's like, what? And I was like, oh, so you have no knowledge of Primus or Vector Sigma, do you? So, like, stand back, because I'm about to drop some mad knowledge on your new ass. And so I explained to him the whole thing of, like, their Bible and everything. Which is really complicated.
They have Bibles?
Kind of. But, like, the whole ideology.
Shit!
Wow.
The ideology.
Yeah, the ideology of that, Oh my god, we have to restart. Oh my god, the game's glitching. Wow.
Okay.
We're just gonna call it quits here, guys, because this is a 31 minute episode.
Okay, yeah, we'll open up next episode with us still doing this. We'll see you next time, the Zegwin Clock.
And Ripper95.
Goodbye.
Peace.